Right, Shalom to the hopeful elect. First, I want to give all praises to Yahweh, Bahasham, Yahweh Shai, Wahar, Rakah Kodash, double honors to the apostles, a great millstone, and salutes to Yoakim that's teaching his word to the hopeful elect. So, there's more earthquakes, man. All right, is earthquakes and different signs that the Lord is showing in the earth that his return is soon, right? And the judgment of the Lord is in the earth, man. You know, and soon it's going to get to the point where the Lord is going to return. And he's going to bring great, great destruction, man. Great judgments for the ways of the wicked in this world, man. Right? So one of the recent earthquakes you've got happening is in Greece, right? All right? It says here 6.3. That was on the 3rd of March, 2021, right? Another earthquake, right? Magnitude 7.2, that's in New Zealand, right? New Zealand, they're experiencing an earthquake and they now got a warning of a tsunami, all right? More judgments, right? This is how the Lord is getting down in these last days, all right? Hang on. Let's see if we can get a little clip here, man. Where is this? All right. And this is all signs, man. A spiritual person is going to identify this and know that this is a signal of the Lord's judgment, all right? And the return of the Lord, all right? This is a sign of his coming, all right? Which I'm going to prove that in the scriptures. All right, hang on, there's more. Hang on. So let's see if we can play this clip. All right, a security camera captures earthquake with preliminary magnitude of at least 6.0 hitting Greece. The earthquake shook clothes on racks as debris fell from the ceiling as seen in the security footage. All right. Well, you can imagine it anyway. It looks like it doesn't want to play. So we'll leave it at that. All right. And you know what? We'll get straight into the scriptures. But you can imagine it. All right. You can picture how much, you know, devastation that would bring. All right. On a country, on a city and the rebuilding, you know, because this is all... like plagues, all right? Look how wicked the world is, man. How wicked the people are in the earth, right? And the Lord has brought great destructions and judgments in the past for cities doing way worse. I mean, doing way less, right? Like Sodom and Gomorrah, all right? And the neighboring cities, all right? And now in this time, you're having things being worse. So these are all leading up to a great destruction, right? This is the book of Isaiah chapter 29 and verse 6. It says, thou shalt be visited of the Lord of hosts of armies, Yahweh, right? With thunder and with earthquake and great noise, with storm and tempest and the flame of devouring fire. And all these things we see in the earth, that shows you that the Lord, when he returns, is going to be with these judgments, these destructions. It's not going to just be everybody's going to be shaking hands and giving everyone high fives. The Lord is coming to punish the wicked. All right? And that's why we're seeing earthquakes. That's why we're seeing storms, hurricanes, floodings, right? Mysterious occurrences, you know, signs in the heavens, meteors, eclipses, blood moons, different phases of the moon. We've been seeing a lot of that, right? Wildfires, all right? All of these are a part of the signs of the Lord. Now, to the spiritual person, right? Namely, the elect, they're going to understand that these are signs, man. You know, it's just as simple as that, right? And the closer the Lord gets, the more we're going to see these signs increase, the more you're going to see judgments happening. All right, this is the book of 2nd Esdras, chapter 9 and verse 1. It says, "He answered me then and said, measure thou the time diligently in itself." Right? And we measure the time with these scriptures according to the Holy Bible, which contains the prophecies, right, of what is going to take place in these last days that the Lord has declared and that has been revealed unto the Lord's prophets, right? The 12 tribes of Israel, which are the so-called blacks, Latinos, and Native Americans, all right? But the chosen few of our nation, right? The elect. It says, "And when thou seest part of the signs pass, which I have told thee before, then shalt thou understand that it is the very same time wherein the highest will begin to visit the world which he made." So when you're reading these scriptures and you're going through the prophecies and you see it take place in the earth, you understand that that has great meaning, all right? That is very important to understand, because you know that what is going to follow after these things is the return of our Lord and Savior, right? The Savior of the 12 tribes of Israel, of the elect. And when the Lord returns, that is going to change the world, right? Because these nations, they're going to be judged. They're going to be punished for the wickedness they've done unto the Lord's people. They're going to be put down out of their wicked rulership, and the Lord is going to rule over all nations in righteousness. The elect Israelites are going to be ruling over the nations and establishing the commandments. That's going to be the kingdom of heaven on the earth for the Lord's people, right? This is the Lord's earth. And right now you have it being defiled, polluted, and completely running wickedness under the rule of the wicked, which are the Edomites, the so-called white people whose father's lineage goes back to Esau. That's who the Lord is coming to put down out of power, man. All right, verse 3 says, "Therefore, when there shall be seen earthquakes and uproars of the people in the world," which we're seeing, protests happening in many countries, people uprising against their governments, people always protesting for the evil that's happening, the pollution, the injustice, the corruption. All right, the people are sorrowful, man, because of the wicked rulers. All right, now I've pulled up all the earthquakes that's been happening just of recently, which if I were to go into it, you would see more happening and more happening all the time. This is a constant thing because these are plagues the Lord is sending, right? The Lord is angry with the wicked every day. So in this world, we know that it's not got much time left, all right? So we're seeing these things that this Bible tells us to be on the look for, all right? We're supposed to seek after these things that if they're happening, right, which they are. Verse 4 says, "Then shalt thou well understand that the Most High spake of those things from the days that were before thee, even from the beginning." So that is going to boost your faith, because you understand that the Most High, through his son, Yahweh Hashem Yahushai, and the prophets, the scriptures, they said that these things would be happening, right? The Lord has said this from the beginning, right? So when we see these things, we know that the Lord is a true power, that his word is living, and it's taking place before our eyes. All right, we're in the end of days, man. All right, and the Lord is going to fulfill his word. Verse 5 says, "For like as all that is made in the world have a beginning and an end, and the end is manifest, even so the times also of the highest have plain beginnings in wonder and powerful works, and endings in effects and signs." Right, so you're going to see miracles, you're going to be seeing mysterious things in the earth, right? You're going to be seeing things that has never been seen before, because that's the days that are coming, a time that's never been seen before, right? You're going to see different signs, man, different sightings of the chariots, all right, the so-called UFOs, the vehicles of the angels, right? How the Lord is going to return, all right? Ultimately, the Lord's coming. Because he's sending his son, Yahweh Shai, which is the image of a so-called black man, according to Revelations. He's going to return and save the elect of his people and bring a great destruction to the nations, man, especially to Esau, right? Because his kingdom, all right, Esau, the wicked, his kingdom has to fall before the kingdom can come on the earth for the Israelites. That's what's coming. All right, he has an end. All right, the scripture says the Lord has appointed his bounds that he cannot pass. So Esau's going to go down in the perfect time, man. And Esau sees these things happening. He sees the earthquakes and the sightings of the UFOs, the chariots, the uproars of the people, everything bubbling over. And he sees that his fall, his collapse is near. All right? But you're going to have the elect that they're going to be hopeful. They're going to know that our salvation is, as the scriptures say, is going to be nearer than when we think. Right, verse 7 says, and everyone that shall be saved and shall be able to escape by his works and by faith, whereby ye have believed. So you're supposed to have faith with works, like the men of the Lord go on the highways and byways as commanded, teach, doing the work, putting up the videos, having faith in the Lord, man. Right, and they're going to be saved. Right, verse 8 says, shall be preserved from the said perils and shall see my salvation in my land. And within my borders, for I have sanctioned them for me from the beginning. All right. But it says, then shall they be in pitiful case. And they are the 2/3 of our people that don't repent. Right. The ones that mock and that scoff and say, oh, this is lies. Oh, the Bible ain't true. And all those that are filthy. All right. In their mindset. Right. They're defiled in their mind. They don't believe in the Lord or the scriptures. They don't have faith. They're going to be in pitiful case, right? The worst situation, because when this all comes to pass, it's going to be too late for them to return to the Lord, right? If you're not of the elect, then you are going to be destroyed along with the nations, right? There's going to be great dangers and evils happening in these last days, man. The riots, Jacob's trouble, World War III, all these prophecies are going to be happening. The martial law, right? The missiles that are going to be the end of America, which is Babylon, all right, 2/3 are going to be cut off in that land, right? After being chipped, right? Microchipped, mark of the beast, they're going to be in that fiery judgment. So this is not a joke. This is very serious, right? And we're coming closer to that time and the Lord is showing us the signs, right? But the elect are going to be saved, man, right? But it says, then shall they be in pitiful case, which now have abused my ways, and they that have cast them away despitefully shall dwell in torments. For such as in their life have received benefits and have not known me. It says, and they that have loathed my law while they had yet liberty, and when as yet a place of repentance was open unto them, they understood not, but despised it. The same must know it after death by pain. Right? And that's really it, man. 2/3, they look down upon faith and this word trusting in Yahweh Bashmi Shai. So what's going to happen? The Lord is going to reject them in the time when of their trouble, when they cry out and try and seek the Lord. He's not going to hear them. They're going to be given over to the famine. They're going to be given over to the sword when Esau comes with great wrath. All right. So I'm going to end it there. Lord willing, it was edifying. All praises to Yahweh Bashmi Shai, Waharuka Kodash, and to the faithful, hopeful elect. Keep pushing and stay strong. And we're nearly out of here. All right. So with that, I'll leave it there until the hopeful election. Shalom.